All right, guys, welcome to our athletic development class. Today, we're gonna do a lot of work below the hips. You're gonna start in this right away for me. So you're gonna get down into your ape squat, and we're gonna do a couple of things to start. You're gonna loosen up and get those hips low, feet flat, open up the ankles, hips, knees. I'm gonna explain to you why as you do this. So you're gonna sit in this pose, try and get flat, get nice and low, ease into it, but also we're just gonna get comfortable rocking side to side. You're gonna spend a good minute here. Second thing I want you to do as we do this is actually close your mouth and breathe through your nose. Couple of things we're trying to do: promote nasal breathing in a very relaxed state. Breathing through the nose slows down your breath, will keep you in a more parasympathetic calm state, which is where the flow state lies. You watch a good MMA fighter, Adesanya, he's walking around for as long as he can in that fight, no nasal breathing, okay? And it's when a fighter loses their breath, starts overpanting, often the commentators will be like, they're out. So you're not gonna be able to, without maybe a year of training, be able to do physical activity through nasal breathing, but you can do all of this stuff with nasal breathing and do it for as long as you can. Second thing we're gonna focus on, you're gonna do an extra minute here while I explain it. And now you're gonna just start to open up the hips though. Open up the hips that way and just play left to right for the next minute. If you look at any great athlete, look at the best ball handlers in basketball, Iverson, Kyrie Irving, you got a soccer, Messi. What do these people all have in common? They're almost glued to the floor. They're low. They almost are one with the floor. Even Messi just dribbles. It's like he's connected to the floor. Basketballers better down here than their opposition. They can get around. So with that in mind, you need to get very good, whatever your sport is, even if you're a sprinter and go, hey, I don't go touch the ground. Guess what? You get loose through all here. It's going to give you extra range, help you sprinting. Your times are going to go through the roof. But we want to get used to being one with the floor. And the problem with modern living is we get cut off at the hips. We become very uncomfortable down here. You look at a good surfer, they can pop up, low, twist, turn, have a lot of strength from down low. So now we've been doing this for nearly 2 minutes. Now we're going to externally rotate and open the hips this way. And then you internally rotate, winding in, winding across. For this one, you can keep the knees quite low. We're working more on mobility. We're gonna go to strength soon. But from here, you can go external with the knee, balance, internal. Internal or both. Internal, external. And you may start to feel this all around the knees, but it's a big part of like a bulletproof knee protocol as well. Get in your hands, if you're really tightening up and need to, can open up your stance, use your hands. I just want you to become one with the floor. I want you to look at the full surroundings of your environment, almost like it is all you. So I'm imagining now this whole studio, I can see behind me, I'm one with the floor. I want to become more one with the floor than my opposition. Same with surfing, you can get good low, you become one with the wave. All sports, you get one with the ground, one with the environment. And if you really want to connect with it, what they'll do in spiritual practice, breathe in through the floor, breathe out. So you're dispersing all the energy from the earth through you. Very common exercise with surfers. I'll just sit in the water, breathe in, connect with the energy of the waves, breathe out, connect with it. And just build your awareness, almost like a meditative practice, just looking around, connected to your environment, becoming one with it, aware of the space. Your energy is connected to that space. We've been going like 3 minutes opening now. We can pop up, shake it out. We want to always be opening up our hips. Nearly all sports is a lot of compression, push off, take off. So I'm always getting athletes, loosen up. You can just be around the lounge room. I just want you being good, build your style, wind. Almost you can be able to come in and fire a kick. You've got control, soft, tight, fast. So you can even come into this now, practice this flow, up, around, strong hips, a lot of balance, control, high, pause, low, in. And you can start to speed, build your speed, style. It's almost martial arty, but just always opening, strengthening those hips as well. To strengthen them as well, we can go out, hold, in, out, hold, in. You watch a lot of pro sprinters and NFL guys right now, they'll even just do a lot of holds here. Knee above the hip. So do this with me and activate, foot active. Straight line, strong core. Little pause, switch. Get active through the hip flexors. Neutral spine, strong shoulders, power, balance. If you wanna go more advanced, put little ankle weights on. Got a kettlebell, Put your foot in it. We're gonna get real strong through the hip flexors. Do it slow though. You can advance and add little things to this workout. But just a little longer, loosening the hips. Get the leg out for a little hold. Out for a little hold. Forward for a little hold. Forward for a little hold. Out for a little hold. We just want to get strong with our limbs every which way. Loose. And get the knees windy. Get them used to the circular motions. Ankles the same. We're going to come back to that. We're going to go back down now, because what we do when the hips are low, great, we're opening up all the major joints low, becoming one with the ground. Now I want you to build strength doing that same thing. So what we're going to do is come off. So my bums is low, there's no strength here. I'm pretty much just mobilizing joints, a little bit in the transition. We come up, we'll look at this as like level 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and up. We're gonna work from levels 1 to 5 and become very strong in all those ranges. So we're gonna go through level 1, let's go. Internal, internal, external, external. Be careful if you've got really bad knees, you've had knee recos, use a hand, we'll slowly work into it. Coming up to level 2, external, external, internal, internal, 3. Coming up, levels, bum down. When you get strong, you may start to feel in, externally rotates. Let's get used to floating, we go back down. All the way to 0. Work back up to 1, strong, winding, get those hips up and down. You're gonna go a little longer than me. And just keep working all those ranges, up, down, another 20 or so. Little pause if you need to. Little pause, little pause. You'll start to hit all the activation around major joints, build rock solid joints here. And now we can actually come into a bit of an ape squat. Little wider, bending side to side. Get lower, level 0. Trying to get those hips as low as we can. Level 0, level 1, level 2, level 3, level 2. Level 1, level 0. More advanced, just get that foot flat. Here, mine's a bit tight today, I just finished a leg session myself. Get low, we're strong low, we're warm. We wanna get so much more comfortable than anyone else below the hips, extending the range. Get that foot flat. Base foot up, or long foot up, should I say. Use hands, if you wanna get through this Cossack, you always learn it by just using your hands. So when I did my yoga course, they would just get you to sit like this for 2 minutes and then bring your hands forward. And if you want to get more advanced, do this with some weights. Almost like just a Cossack, up through all the different levels. 1, up, 2, 3. 15 more seconds to go, but the idea is to just build so much time under tension under these mobile positions and get so rock solid down low. You're going for 5, 4, 3, 2, and we're coming into our animal flow. So very similar to that motion. We're gonna come into a low dragging lateral monkey glide. So I start as far wide of the mat as I can. My energy's all the way to the right. My weight's there. I come across, keeping the hips low. And float as wide as I can the other time. Float across. And it's a big core exercise. Let's go, we're going for a full minute here. My core is really activating to take the weight out of my movement. And I'm just becoming one with the floor so I can just get so comfortable. And you can just keep floating left to right. Another 30. A lot of core strength, a lot of activation around the deep core, which is not just your abs, it's all the way around the hips. Adductors, adductors, obliques, glutes. Get strong, get low. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and shake it out. Just to get you in the motion of opening up, we go back, opening up the hips, both directions. Strong. Have a good recovery here. It's more about performance. Good athletes are generally doing enough rigorous endurance stuff. This is just about building your style. Kick that bum, internally rotate. Try and go through the nose, test it. You will calm your heart rate down much faster nasally breathing. Bigger, deeper, stronger breaths. Excellent. We're going to go into the duck walk. We're also going to work level 0, 1, 2, and 3. So the level 0 duck walk, one knee up, one knee down, is more mobility. When we're just starting, it's a bit clunky like this. Let's start. As we get better, we become soft. Zero impact, because my knees, and I'm twisting and turning, staying light. We're going to go through that for a full 30 seconds. Just keep circling around the mat, getting lighter. Glide, take your weight off the movement, your body. Build your style. Got another 10. This is level 0. Bad news for you, level 1 gets much harder. We're going in 5, 4, 3, 2. Now we just come off, see, to level 1. A lot of strength building here, especially watch your knees. If you get any burning knees, slow it down. Level 1, still touch the knee. I'm hovering, touch the knee, both directions. Get rock solid. You're gonna build so much strength around the glutes and knees. What's that gonna do? It's gonna make you more powerful takeoff both ways. Good down low. You're gonna get an unfair advantage over the competition. Have a little rest. Recovery breath through the nose. One more. How much better does that feel than breathing through the mouth? It's a powerful energy exchange. Now we're gonna go up to level 2. Even harder, for 30. Let's go. It's almost like a mini duck walk lunge. Tap. Still tapping that knees. Coming up to that next level. We want to be strong on every single level. Level 0, level 1, level 2, 3, 4, 5. Everyone's good on 5. Changing directions. Build that strength around the knees, the quads. Another 10. Come up a little higher to 3. All the way down. Good. 3, 2, 1. Relax. So those two major moves, the low lateral monkey duck walks, the 8 squat, twisting and turning, building most hypermobile tendons, super strong stabilizers, but most importantly, when that ball hits the deck, we are more one with the ground. Our takeoff is quicker than anyone else. We just get that unfair advantage. We're gonna move up the body. We will come back to some legs later. I wanna get you guys in a rock solid core. One of the biggest things we wanna do with a rock solid core is train neutral spine. One of my favorite exercises. High plank, do not let that lower back collapse at all. The core has to be on neutral for that to happen. Engage there. We're gonna go for a full minute. Up here, the neutral spine, pressing away from the floor. What I'm doing by pressing away from the floor is activating through here and here to create space, less impact on the joints. We become very light movers. That's what we're doing. Zero impact on the joint because the muscles do all the work. Now, we're gonna tap the shoulder. See, my hips do not move a single millimeter. If yours are doing that, you need to squeeze more. Engage the whole thing together. We're going for 45 more with the shoulder taps. A bonus 15 for you. A little pause there if you can. One leg up makes it even harder. Neutral spine. Strong core. Rest in plank when you need to. Do not let that lower back dip one bit. Create space, lightness. To be a great athlete, you want to navigate around everything like you're light. So much strength and power around the joints. Everything feels easy. Quick light push off. Everything is just effortless. We're going for 10 more. Keep those shoulder taps going. Neutral spine. Tuck that tailbone even more. And relax. We're going to do another variation of that. Go back to the nasal breathing. I just want you to keep training nasal breathing. And always just good posture. Nice neutral spine, shoulders open. We're going to do that same exercise with a push-up in between. So, the advanced movement. Neutral spine. There. See, my hips do not move. You want to make it even harder? Opposite legs comes back. We're going to go for 45. Let's go. Building rock solid core. Balance. Everything in between. The longer you can pause here, the tougher. We're bringing in strength from the quads, all around the hips. You're just building locks, 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 rock solid. So So if you're in a 10-pack squat, someone tackles you, just rip them off you. You've got a much stronger endurance through this region. We're gonna go for another 15. Hips stand still. Freeze. Pause. Jump for another 3, 2, 1. Relax. Other thing I want you guys to think about, anytime you're in the gym training, is all yang compression. Decompress. Open. Your recovery should be just opening, creating a balance of that yang activity with a yin activity. Open up the shoulders. Create space in the hips like we did before. Loosening, expanding, releasing. So the essence of all those movements are to stay light. So strong through the deep, everything engaging together to create lightness and mobility. Stay light, stay relaxed through the breath to make you a super athlete. One more upper body exercise I want to give you space for. Most people do a side plank. Even though I train a lot of elite athletes that sit like this, sinking into the shoulder joint, wrist, cores off, and they struggle. We want to create space and length. We're going to go for 5, 4, 3, 2, float to the other side. Height, look how much height I have. There's no pressure on my wrist, core, or shoulders because I'm getting space and length. Other side, now bring the leg up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, other side. 5, 4, shoulder weight stacked over the hand. 3, 2, 1, we're gonna put a rock solid side body with this as well, which is gonna help our core. 4, 3, 2, 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push up in between. Float. Build your style, control, body-mind connection. 3, 2, 1. Up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, push up, plank high, light, press through. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So these exercises are all training. That's non-neutral spine. When our spine's like this, core is off, back issues, athletes are front and center. Tuck, you're getting active through here. Tuck the tailbone, engage here. Pillars are always built straight, never with a curve. So you're in the strongest position in your athletic performance. It's here, neutral spine, overactive through here. Thin, on, protecting spine, obliques on, building a rock solid core. That's why this exercise you did earlier, knee up, neutral spine. Knee down often, we'll sink into it. So I want you always worried about your breath. Core, shoulders in line, everything's always self-correct. Shoulders, deep core, neck, all one line. Not head forward, core off, tilting, hinging forward. We rock solid head to toe. Gonna do a little exercise, which you guys are gonna be super fit for, but we're just building our style. Great for our prehab, rehab around the Achilles, knees, float, bounce, float. And just getting used to being light, my energy goes up. And we can go fast. Just practicing your takeoff speed. Quick, quick, quick. And then you can go to pedal. So playing with all. Up high, high. Impact goes there. We're just low impact. We build low impact by being great up here. Look at a good boxer. Always on their toes. We throw the bounce into it. And then no bounce, speed. Fast as you can, quicker takeoff speed. Play with those two for another 20. Fast as you can, keeping your weight down. The more weight is oneness with the ground, easy to go faster, turning off. Another 15, we need a rest, float, glide, bit of speed. We wanna be high all the time. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And what I wanted you to think about, even when you walk, strong core, light, easy. We don't need to expel so much energy by even the way we walk. This is energy expelling. Heavy on the feet, heavy on the hips. You don't walk around recovering like this. It's light. Nasal. Almost like a fighter prepping. You don't want to be between a fight, out of breath. Strong, soft, light, circular, nasal breath. Keep another nasal. We're going to do a full body mobility exercise, the scorpion kick through. This is great because you've got full body mind control. We're building awareness, new neuromuscular activity, connectivity. So you just can control limbs flying left, right, and center. We start in basically a down dog. Bend the knees. We launch the left leg up. Float it around. Try and control that all the way down. Like that. We come back onto that right arm. Switch arms. That left leg keeps moving. Long and low. Eventually, you can go fast, slow to a point where I could stop here, 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 or here. That is what I would call full body awareness. Control, let's go. You're gonna do 45 seconds each side. I'll go with you again. Left hooks around, soft, gentle landing, bum comes down. Back onto the right, switch hands, left leg goes low and wide laterally. Back around, build some speed. Style as you get better. Power, control. We want to be out of here fast. Stop, gentle, finesse, control, and flow. Couple more. Long, float, strong, open, and switching sides. I'm going to instruct the first one. Right leg hooks up, around, soft landing, switch arms. Right leg comes through, float, open, expand, float back, long, smooth, control, long, float back, kick through, float, long, control, float, kick through, pause, 3, 2, 1. If you need to pause this video and you want to practice any of these, do so. Go a little longer. From here, nice and, wouldn't call it an easy one. We're gonna practice getting those knees over toe as far as they go. So, I start here and try and control, build rock solid knees, whoa, all the way down. The hardest spot is to hover. Use your hand when you need to, millimeter, float into our squat. Smooth down. Again, we're gaining full body mind connection, control with our knees as far from the body as we can get them. Smooth, leaning back, hover, back to our ape squat. Keep going around that. As you get better, that will lead into going into like your sissy. Use your hand, float back up. Gauge the glutes, tilt back. With these, it's important. You feel anything around the knees, just drop. Let go. You want to work this over time. You can play with either. Playful exercise, land gracefully if you are gonna fall. Control. Back into our little ape. Wah. Use your hands, use your legs when you need to, your hands when you need to, especially under fatigue. And then when you're doing your full, like I call it the Neo, get ready to just use that hand, pop back up. Gonna build bulletproof knees, knees under full range, can't get any more knee over toe. And relax. Again, you want to practice that further. Pause, go again. As we go back to our ape squat, this is our home position. I want you here every day, morning, night, lunch, becoming one with the floor, getting good low. And now one of the things I do for surfers, but it's great for everyone, barrel. Imagine you're holding the rail, barrel, backhand, forehands. Barrel, stay low, like you're ducking for cover in that wave. Ducking. Ducking, get low. And then what a good surf will do in the barrel. Hop back up, down, up, down, other side. Up, down, other side. We're gonna do this for a full minute. Down, up, down, other side. Other side, good surfers can ride the barrel, pop up, ride it back out. You get a nice high score at pipe. There, but an average surfer, they don't wanna be here too long. They're either trying to get here, or here, but we get strong through winding, surfing, building that circular motion. We're gonna go for another 15. Up, down, I'm starting to fatigue. Third workout of the day. Back, last 10. Go for 3 count now. And up, 1 more for 3. 2, 3, and up. Give that bum a kick. Nasal breathe. retrain it. I think this latest science shows leaning over is good for your recovery. But all we're doing through here is getting mighty open and strong around the ankles, knees, bending, twisting, strong, mobile, and we get good down here. And if you think about, we'll do this now, so once you're getting used to that figure eight, all I'm doing now, energy, energy, energy. So watching, and if you watch a good surfer or skater, it's all whole body. Carving eights and getting that will get you a stronger turn, that strength. A little bit sport specific, we're not gonna go through that today. Just getting used to twisting, turning, exaggerate it, get a little lower, even lower, and no rules, just circling, and have a stretch, shake it out. One of my other favorite stretches to get me ready for athletic performance, flat foot, lean behind, open up. I glide my hands, building strength in the transition, open the side body. We'll make it harder, extend that foot. We can also get around, stretch, open up the hip flexors. Side stretch, foot down, stretch. Yeah, and we're just getting so comfortable, low. And you can even come around like that. No rules with your flow. And that's what I want you guys to be able to do, is just flow, not think. Free the mind, get windy, get floaty, and relax. Our lack of hip mobility is the killer of most of this. So to finish, I want you always practicing the 90-90. Now, nearly everyone gets this wrong, so we're gonna use the mat. Everything works in lines with this mat. My quad, in line with the mat. My shin, in line with the mat. This quad, parallel lines. This foot, this calf, lines. 90, 90. As we face front on, a lot of you guys are gonna get stuck here, very tight around here. We wanna get straight, upright. You can tilt forward, come back up. As you get more advanced, you can externally rotate like that, and even come for a little hover. Build deep, deep strength. Raise the back, raise the front, raise the foot, raise the knee. Switching internally, rotating there. Now see, I'm out. That is not 90, that's not 90. You might not be able to see. Readjust, 90, 90. 90, foot's at 90. I go back. I'm pretty straight there. I've got a mirror here. Tilt forward. This glute, not as good as the right. You can see, doesn't like that external rotation. Raise and hold, raise. So this side doesn't like it as much. I'm feeling more of a pinch there. Float back around. You will loosen up a lot with each one. And then you can flow through it a little quicker, playing with all the different maneuvers. Strength, opening, all the areas where we suffer the most. Go for another 15. You can go into a little hold if you like. I'm not at 90, gonna readjust. You can do a little twist as well if you like. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Returning to a seated position, nasal breathing. In for 5, out for 5 is the best breath for increasing heart rate variability, which basically means you can recover better, which is what we all want. So in for 5, out for 5 is the breath you want to train all the time. Monks spend decades training that breath to walk around. 5 in, 5 out. You can do it with nasal breathing. It's going to change the whole way your body recovers. It's going to speed up recovery, improve oxygen absorption. Number one thing athletes need. Improve nitric oxide, blood flow. The benefits are just endless. And that is the end of the flow today. If you want to advance that, add weight to the duck walks, to your leg, doing all those things. Press pause, go a little bit longer if you really want to excel in those. But this will make you a super athlete, sprinting, jumping, basketball, football, soccer, wrestling. Great for recovery as well. Go kick ass at whatever sport you are thriving in.